that was passed last year by the Obama administration, it will not allow sodas and the junk food in any school. So now these new companies are coming out.
These new companies are coming out with brilliant new ideas. One of them is called Fresh Healthy Vending. It's a San Diego franchise that actually worked with a school district to implement these new fresh healthy vending machines. And
That's
so they don't sell sodas. Instead, they sell smoothies and juices. And they offer snacks like carrots and other fresh vegetables.
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, they have some things in there that are kind of skirting the line. Their most popular item in the vending machine is called Pirate's Booty Cheese Puffs, which are the best seller, but it's an alternative to these other vending machines that are in these schools. And I think if I was a kid and I had a choice between a soda and a machine like this, I'd probably make the healthy choice, especially with the education around eating healthy. If you give them the choice, they'll make the right choice.
If you had the tiger mom, that's what you would have.
Ramesh, have you ever heard that a woman's tears will turn a man into mush?
Yes.
Well, apparently there is now scientific evidence that shows that that may in fact be the case. This is just such an interesting story. So apparently there is new research that suggests that much of the response that men experience is involuntary. The smell of a woman's tears in a study that was done is associated with a dip in testosterone, which is, of course, the principal male hormone, and a general decline in sexual arousal. You know, the one thing that's unique about humans is we cry out of emotion, whereas animals don't generally cry out of emotion because we don't know that they have emotion. But these emotional tears actually trigger different responses in people. Now, the study also will tell you that, you know, men cry. They have emotions. They haven't gotten to that point where they've been able to study what the effect of male tears are on the female, but they have identified that female tears will cause a dip in testosterone. So, in fact, men will actually turn into mush
when women cry. When you see a woman crying, oh, my God, everything goes down. Forget about just one or two things. Everything goes down. You're not coherent when you reply to a woman's tears. There is no reply to a woman's tears.
It's true. It causes a psychological shift away from baser male impulses. Who knew?
But please don't use it too much.
It's our secret weapon.
Yes. Folks, BBC News is reporting that there has been an open letter written to Prime Minister Manmohan Singh by a group including industrial bankers and judges. They're warning of widespread governance deficit almost in every sphere of national activity. They're talking about corruption. They're saying corruption has permeated almost at every level, and it should need to be looked at as if you're going to war, and an immediate agency need to be set up to look into the corruption. Now, some of the signatories in that letter are like Keshav Mahindra, Jamshed Godrej, of course, everybody knows Godrej, Anu Aga, Judges Sam Vairava and B.N. Sri Krishna, former Reserve Bank of India Governor M. Narasimhan, RBI Central Board Directors Yesti Malagam, Vidyanathan, bankers Deepak Parekh and N. Wagal, financial services expert Nachiket M.O.R. and M.P. Ashok Ganguly.
So you've got some heavy hitters.
Yeah, I mean, they are very afraid that India is going to really go backwards. They're going to have a tremendous demonstrations, as it is, they're happening right now. But they believe that corruption is an extremely bad enemy that needs to be handled. Let's hope Prime Minister Manmohan Singh will do something.
And I am so happy to see something like this actually take place in India for two reasons. One, look at the embarrassment we experienced over the Commonwealth Games. That was only a few months ago. And
that's
we were down
there,
to the wire. Granted, things went off without a hitch and, you know, all that bad press, ultimately all's well that ends well, we were fine. But still, people who are looking to do business in India, if they have to encounter corruption there on a daily basis as a general practice, think about how much that hinders the country from progress.
Oh, yeah.
You know, that's like the weak bone in it's your Achilles heel in otherwise brilliant country that has so much potential. It's the one thing that will, you know, make a sour taste in your mouth just in having to do business dealings.
That's true. You know, you are as strong as your weakest link. And that is the weakest link. And they believe that there is a deficit in governance and it should be corrected.
And there's good reason to do it. Here's a story that caught my eye. Starbucks is finally coming to India.
Yes.
You know, it's a matter
of time.
They're
in China. They have 1,500 locations.
They're in China, and it's surprising, actually, that they haven't gone after India yet, although they say India remains one of the big untapped markets for the Seattle-based coffee and food company, because India is as large an opportunity for them as China is.
Yes.
And in fact, India has a strong culture of tea and of coffee. I didn't know this. India is a coffee exporter, the fifth largest in the world, according to the U.S. Department of Agriculture. So, you know, people are drinking there, and it's just surprising to me that Starbucks hasn't yet launched itself, although they'll be pairing up with some Indian companies to launch themselves in India. I hope it doesn't squash the Indian local-grown shops there. That's my one concern anytime you have a big conglomerate go overseas.
Let me tell you, in Bombay, there used to be Irani restaurants on every corner. You know, that was the chai wala. The chai shop was always there. And they were all lost because of the amount of rental that they were asking. So right now you have the chaiwalas in a illegal facility, you know. Right. So now for these guys to get in, I mean, I don't know. In India, it'll be very hard for people to grab a tea or coffee outside unless it is a to-do thing. I mean, if it was, you know,
well, it is
fashionable to be seen there, yeah, it's doable. But otherwise, I don't see that. I mean, their culture is not like our culture here. We live alone. So many young people live alone. There, they don't live alone.
Maybe they don't live alone. But I think what you do have is you have a strong influence of American television in India. And there, you're always talking about going to Starbucks or going to a coffee shop. And there is a certain bourgeois feeling that goes along with that if you're a new middle class, nouveau riche. So there's a lot of things that are being adopted. I remember one of the first trips I took to India, the biggest thrill for them, my cousins, was to take me to go and have iced tea. You know, iced tea is not a big deal for us because we pour it for ourselves with every meal. But for them to actually go someplace, sit down and have an iced tea was a big deal. And that was just a Western influence coming from magazines, coming from TV shows. So you never know.
I remember when I was younger that we will go 20 minutes of bus ride. You can't afford taxis at that time. 20 minutes of bus ride to go to Connaught Place to have a cup of coffee there, you know. And then walk 2 hours in Connaught Place, do window shopping, which is, and then you take a bus and you go home. So I can see maybe that kind of, maybe it'll work. Yeah.
It'll be interesting to see also if Starbucks keeps its sort of look.